Hi, welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick. It is a very special day for Channel 31, as we've been given a reprieve by the Communications Minister, Mitch Fifield, who we like very much now. We've been given 6 more months on free to air. And in line with what we do on Channel 31, I've got a special guest who's going to tell us about what she does to make the world a better place. And her name is Kylie Appel.
Thank you for having me.
Well, that was a mouthful.
We certainly do, follow the same, principles. We certainly do make a difference and change the lives of many. I was lucky enough to be project manager for Tikun Olam Makers, a global non-for-profit. It's a movement that started in Israel, and we hosted the very first Australian Tom Makeathon. Tom in Hebrew translates, or Tikun Olam, I should say, in Hebrew translates to repair the world or change the world. And Makeathon is, if you think about, the old-fashioned hackathon-style event, that's exactly what Tom's about. It's about bringing together makers, so teams of engineers, scientists, designers, OT specialists, together with need-knowers. That's people who are living with a disability. They work collaboratively together for 72 hours to work on and to solve real life challenges that these people are facing. So the whole idea behind Tom is that, if people in our local community are living with particular challenges, there are obviously many, many, many more people around the world who are suffering the same challenges. So we're hoping that we can solve problems for many. In fact, Tom's global mission is to impact the lives of 250 million people around the globe over the next decade. So now that we've hosted Tom in Australia, we're just that one step closer to achieving that vision.
And your leader in Australia is Debbie Dadon.
Absolutely. Debbie Dadon AM. She is the visionary. She's the leading force behind bringing Tom to Melbourne. She was lucky enough to witness a Tom Makeathon happening in Israel last year. Mm-hmm. And she was extremely humbled and excited and, just so passionate about the whole Tom experience that, she decided to bring it to Australia. And, it was just an incredible experience for Debbie to, A, see it, what happens behind the scenes overseas, and then, be the key force in actually making it happen in Australia. Yeah.
Well, I was there. You invited me so kindly, and I was so blown away to go to Swinburne University of Technology to this major lecture area where there were people, and there were 10 teams.
That's right. There were 10 teams, and I have to say that Swinburne University were our event host, and they were incredible. The innovation precinct there, allowed our teams to have access to state-of-the-art, technology, 3D printers, their workshop rooms. There were people, running all around the university for 72 hours. And yes, there were 10 teams, incredible teams of made up of makers and need knowers. So what's unique about Tom is that each team were able to work passionately to really understand what the challenges were by working directly with their need knowers. So to really understand and embrace the actual challenge that they have today. So unlike in other, makeathons and events where people work, in silo or independently, it's a real team effort. It's a collaboration. There were 10 incredible teams,
I managed to film the presentation at the end, which I thought was really very exciting to see the people who were the team, and they had screens up the top where they were showing all the different methods that they used and the incredible technology that they found at very affordable prices. They really kept it down, because the problem I find with people with disabilities is that they need to get things to help them, to aid them, but a lot of them are way out of the cost.
That's right. Unfortunately, the way it works in disability, a lot of the assistive technology devices are unaffordable. So with Tom, we are able to come up with ways and solutions that are affordable. To give you an example, 3D printers were in abundance, thank you to the MakerBot community, who are a global partner of Tom. They were able to, to loan us incredible 3D printing facilities and machines. So I think it was team number 2, they designed a robotic head neck support for one of our need knowers.
That was amazing.
There was another team who created an assistive device to
help Stacey.
Well, Stacey's a young girl who's travelling independently overseas next year, and she's in a wheelchair. She has muscular dystrophy, and we were able to create a device for her to travel on uneven terrain and to get up and down comfortably with steps, shops, cafes. So she's travelling to Europe to get for the first time.
And one of the people involved with that was Joel Kuper.
Joel Kuper. He was an absolute clown. Well, he was talented. He was a champion. You took the words out of my mouth. He was an absolute champion.
We've had Joel on before, and he's definitely a leader of the future. Got to keep your eye on Joel Kuperholz.
Absolutely.
And the other person who was there that was very excited and was so exciting to meet was Michal.
Oh, Michal Kabatznik, an absolute champion of Tom.
Yes, she was too.
She was a pleasure to have, you know.
So she's the Israeli representative that goes to all the makeathons.
Absolutely. So Michal's role is creator of global opportunities. Mm-hmm. And she's got the lucky gig where she gets to travel around the globe to help, you know, people like me and Debbie put on a Tom, you know, for the first time in our own country. She said that, you know, the Melbourne event was probably one of the best that she's ever been to. Mm-hmm. I mean, we had over 100 volunteers working on Tom in Melbourne. That's, you know, 10 teams of makers paired to, you know, one or two need knowers per team. I mean, that was huge. And she was fantastic. Huge. She actually came to Australia for the pre-Tom event. Mm-hmm. And that's a really, really important part of the Tom experience. The pre-Tom is the first time where the need knowers meet their teams and they get given their challenges. So they are told what their particular projects are going to be, and then they have 72 hours to solve that particular challenge. They had a month to meet, to plan, to work out their, you know, their projects. And yes, Swinburne were a fantastic host, so we couldn't have done it without them.
Well, it's been really great to have you as a guest on the Shtick. I'm sorry Debbie couldn't come today, but we'll have her on next time with one of her other initiatives or talk more about Tom, because it really is, and it's a long-term proposal, isn't it?
It is.
I mean, there's way down the track.
Oh, there's lots of things. I mean, this is just the first phase for Tom. There's Tom maker communities now where we're hoping our teams will actually meet to further develop the prototypes that are made. Mm. And then next year in 2017, Tom Global are launching the Tom Open Innovation Platform. So what that means is that all the prototypes that are developed around the globe are available online. So anybody or any country or any organisation or any individual.
Can you imagine the possibilities?
I know.
It's going to be amazing.
It's going to be great. So they can access the technology, download it from anywhere they are, and we will be able to celebrate the success of Tom around the globe.
Fantastic. Thank you so much,
no
Kylie.
No worries. Thank you for having
and
me.
And we'll be back after the break with Newt's News, his final Newt's News for the year, with the summation of the year. We're going to be talking to Paul Rosenberg about his initiative, getting silent disco for kids, in segment 3. We'll see you then.